we're back. Hello.
Hi.
Now so, we're going to find where we're going. Okay, so in the future, what is the Overwatch meta right
so
now?
So right how? So
in the past, technically.
In the past, actually, since because I don't know when this is going to be uploaded exactly.
Never.
That's not true.
that's not true.
But,
February 22nd.
February 22nd.
So, hopefully they don't change the meta. Because, you know, there's updates that change the meta, like this one. And then there's updates that just, like, fix a few things. But they don't really change the meta. Because this one's really changing the meta a bit. Because, first of all, Anna and Lucio are going to take in the top range of healers.
Well, yeah, because Anna's, like, literally the best burst healer.
Because Anna's grenade is now actually... But she's going to be a lot easier to deal with, because Anna's grenade,
yes,
new update,
know. Yeah, know
now 50%
yeah,
less
I was,
healing.
No, I remember I heard the... I know what the patch notes are. My favorite meme right now is nerf D.Va, nerf this, K. Wait, no.
Because
D.Va's nerf was pretty...
Oh, D.Va's nerf is pretty heartbreaking for someone like me who plays a lot of D.Va.
Yeah.
But you know what? She's still really usable.
I guess.
No, I was watching. Like I said, I was watching the video, and the guy was saying as well. Like, she's still very usable. Because if you look at it, like, the only thing now is that she's killable, more so than she was before.
Yeah.
But
hell
she's
yeah.
not. She's still just as strong.
Because armor works completely different.
If not, she's actually maybe she not that she does more damage, but she. She deals that damage maybe a little quicker because they upped her amount, the amount of bullets that
she
fires.
No, she deals two less because of how everything.
Well,
works.
she deals two less. Yes, no, she only does. They took it down from 3 to 2.
Yeah, so she deals. I think. And how many does she shoot?
She shoots 11 now.
Yeah, so it's instead of what was it 3 to 12.
Mm-hmm.
It's two to 11. So I think the math was she loses 2 damage. That's still a lot.
She can still hold a point, which is really good. I use her mainly in control points. I use her in control point maps, specifically Nepal. She's really good.
Yes, I know.
You know the map
Nepal,
where you're in the middle?
Yeah.
If you just fly in as D.Va and stand there the whole match, you know, for the most part, you're fine.
Unless they're you know, good players.
Well, here's the other thing too, is that it's not a matter of that. It's like it's also good for your team to get to the point.
Oh yeah,
because you can hold
a tank. That's your job.
Because D.Va's thing is that because of how much health she has, and this is good for use for me. Like, if I like get wrecked, it still buys some time.
I feel
like what matters is that it's like with other tanks. Like if I get wrecked, I'm dead. That's it. And then I have to run back. And that's it. But with D.Va, if I get wrecked, I'm out of my thing, and I'm smaller. And I bounce around a bit. Whenever I play D.Va, I don't run. If you run away when you lose your mech, you're a bitch, D.Va.
Because
her pistol does some good damage.
Yeah, it can.
And you should fucking try to use it. Plus, you can get your mech back pretty fast. Like, have you ever...
Oh, it's in Eden.
Have you ever looked at, like, how much she gets back of her mech? Like, of getting her mech back, like, whenever she fires one bullet?
No, I haven't. It's a strange...
But,
I have not looked back. I don't play D.Va that much, so I don't.
But, yeah, whenever you shoot, like, her pistol, like, the charge of her ultimate to get her mech back is, like, so quick.
Like, as long as you hit, right?
Well, you hit, but it's not that difficult to hit, especially if you play the game for a while.
I don't know, man, that one Lucio guy.
She does not have...
That one Lucio guy, come on, man.
That one Lucio guy?
That one Lucio guy that played on console. Everyone's like, you can't do this on PC. And he did.
It's good. Well, I'm just saying
I'm just saying
there's no arc to her fire.
Yeah, there's no... It's
so
straight.
You don't have to calculate anything.
If
you fire wildly, your chains are... You'll hit a shot.
God.
If you just go, you'll hit a shot.
I think my favorite thing ever was, like, a D.Va trying to think she was cool, trying to fight us, and she was out of her mech, and then you just Roadhog hook her.
Oh, either you Roadhog hook her, or there's my favorite thing, fucking 3v3 elimination.
That game, though, I like the arcade mode.
I love
arcade
arcades.
Mode was
fun. 3v3, I played Reinhardt one match.
Oof.
I fucking come in, it's a Mercy and a D.Va still alive. I hammer down, kills the Mercy, destroys the D.Va's mech. I go to pin, I catch the D.Va mid leaving her mech.
That's always fun.
Win.
No, yeah, because I think the pin does like a lot of damage to D.Va. Like,
well, if she's out of her mech, she's dead.
Yeah, it does enough damage to kill. Like, the squishy characters like that will just die.
I still think, as Juan says, like, Junkrat's does a lot of damage.
He's
not in the competitive scene right now.
Although he's really leaving the competitive scene now.
Is he in the competitive scene? I've been watching ESL. I haven't seen anything.
Junkrat was, like, at least, like would be played, and especially in, like, the lower ranks.
Oh, the lower
ranks. But he's... Chances are he's going to be taken out a bit now because of the recent patch, the recent updates. There's not as many tanks, you know. And while Junkrat does enough damage to kill people easily when they're squishy, that means you have to hit them. Which, while you just
play demo, man. That's what you're doing.
But that's the thing. Like, while you can hit them, it's like if you trust yourself. He's not going to be taken out that much. I'm just saying that.
I had no idea he was in the competitive scene to begin with.
Or the lower ranks, But you know, that's the thing. When you really think about what's actually in the competitive scene in the higher ranks and like Grandmaster and shit, it's kind of boring. Because every people stays to the same characters and it's like.
Well, because all the characters that they're picking are good.
Yeah, I know, but it's like, because there's like so many other characters to play with. Is the thing.
Well, like, yeah, that's the point, but like. The teams give me my problem
with the competitive scene and I have to like really put the warning stamp on this. Like, I'm not one of those people that's like I'm bad, that's why I'm arguing about the I'm not the my thing with the competitive scene is that I don't like how everyone treats it like they're already in esports.
There's a chance
that you can get into the Overwatch League via the fucking the open like search that they'll be doing over time. There's a chance that someone in competitive can get really well and get into Overwatch League, sure, but there's people in lower ranks that are acting like they're already in an esports match and you're not.
Sorry, I just like saying esports.
But the problem is that there's like this difference. There's a difference between just normal competitive play in the game and an esports match where you're getting paid to play the game and everything, and you can win something by winning, you know? But everyone acts like that in normal competitive in low ranks, and it's really annoying. And it actually worsens a team because you have one person that's like that and everyone else isn't, and then they're like, fuck you, man. It's like no one else did anything wrong.
No, that's just how it is, man. It's always been like that for any like competitive.
No, game. I know. But that's my only problem is that there's a lot of people that get salty and ruin.
They
ruin any chances of winning because they're not playing with the team. They're playing against the team.
How do you think playing League of Legends went? That's the same thing. It's always been like that. Like literally.
I never said it didn't. I'm just saying that
Seal Man.
I never said it wasn't always like that. I just don't like that it's like that.
I mean, you got it. Sometimes you just gotta deal with it.
What really annoys me. Well, no, I deal with it. I still play competitive.
Well, obviously.
I don't mind it. I'm just saying if I have to nitpick anything, that's it.
I have to nitpick. Oh, God, no. Jesus. Oh, God.
Because it only annoys me because it, like, it can actually, like, it can make a match just get really annoying.
Well, obviously.
Especially when you play with people like Richard, who takes it as a challenge to fuck with them.
It's Garvulon.
Which, while funny, is just wasting a competitive match.
It's wasting time, more like it.
Wasting time in a competitive match and losing the competitive match because he'll just fuck with them. Because he's like, oh, this guy thinks he's so good, he's so much better than us. Let's show him, we'll put this Maywall in front of him. Like, no, Richard, there's a competitive match. There's a point over there. Let's go get the point. Fuck.
Stop memeing on him and just stop trying to beat him because you guys are just going to get beat.
And then you get those people, then you get the people that get like that in quick play.
Oh, God.
That are annoying as fuck.
I get so tilted in that game sometimes because it's not hard.
It's not.
I think what tilts me, and it's on like the point objective, is when, you know, when you body them really hard the first point, and you're like, yeah, sweet. And then for some reason they just go beast mode on you, and then you just can't. You can't win the game.
The thing that tilts me with competitive, and it's the reason why
I'm not tilted. It just gets me annoyed.
The reason why I'm like, and it's partially the reason why I'm like in lower ranks. The other reason is because I don't have a good PC, and I'm like I'm playing on Blur, and it runs smoothly, and I can't complain about lag or anything. But I can say that it's like, I'm not in any type of competitive mood. I like to think I am, and I get angry like I am. But I'm never in any actual competitive mood. I can walk away from the game and go play something else, fine. Yeah. But the people that are actually in a competitive mood stay on after that. And they try to go all in. Like, balls
deep. You gotta, man. You gotta keep going.
But, and no, that's what I do. But I'm not in the, I'm really not in a heavily competitive mood, like, ever.
Obviously, yeah. No, I feel you.
I'm like...
No, I'm just...
Because it's difficult to be with that game. Because yeah. I want to have fun. And a lot of times when I get that competitive, I stop having fun and I start treating it like there's work to do.
When I think of competitive, I just... Like, because I've been just watching... I have been. And I gotta get back into, like, what's going on in ESL. Because that's, like, you know, that's the real stuff. That's, you know, that's comp, that's esports. And it's just the same. You know, you still got Genji, you still got McCree, you still got Zarya.
Holy shit.
Wow.
Fucking Beyonce, Queen Bee over here.
You got Beyonce, I almost said Beyonce. You got...
Waspmon.
Waspmon!
I love that it's mechanical.
It's pretty cool. You got Zarya, you got Reaper, it's just the same shit.
Reaper's coming back with the new meta. Reaper's coming back.
I mean, Reaper's always been there.
He's been there. No, he's like coming back heavily now. Because there's going to be less tanks with the new meta.
Yeah.
There's going to be less tanks to deal with. Because the only... Roadhog, his new hook is more...
I don't want to talk about it.
Well, no.
I don't want to talk about it.
It's so bad. But it's balanced.
It's so bad. It's like, there's balancing, and then there's making it bad.
Now you earn that insta-kill.
Not if they just move. If they just move behind, like, the smallest tree, you don't get them.
Yeah, but you gotta earn that insta-kill instead of just ripping them up and that's it.
No, I get it. No, it's fine giving Roadhog line of sight. But if you give the hook, if they duck behind, like, a tree after you hook them, you don't. That's bad. That's not good.
Oh, is that the actual change? Like, if you
no,
hook
no,
them?
No, the line of sight isn't the hook anymore. It's Roadhog. But if you hook them and they go behind something, you lose them.
Oh, so...
You don't get them.
So if you hook them and then you move...
No, if you hook them and they move behind something that gets rid of your line of sight, you don't get them.
Hmm.
That's the change, too. That's what they change. If they kept it, Roadhog has to have the line of sight and that's it. That's fine. I'm not complaining about that. That's not what's bad. What's bad is this fucking maze. What's bad is...
I like the look of the area, though.
Yeah, no, it's really nice. But again, that's what I mean is... So, like, say I'm here and you're here and I hook you. You go behind here and I lose you, I don't get you.
Mm.
That's the actual
thing. That's annoying.
That's really...
But I'm sure it'll... They love trying to make something better, and then they fuck up, and they actually make it better.
So, yeah.
That's the meta of creating Overwatch.
That's not the meta of creating Overwatch. That's the meta of Blizzard. Here's the thing, Pete. And I know you don't play a lot of Blizzard games, which is fine. This is, like, the first big Blizzard game you played. But I'm going to run you through how Blizzard makes a meta and what they do.
All right.
Oh, you were broken? Okay. I'm going to make you not broken. And now, see this guy? Now it's your turn. They do their meta in turns. First it was... McCree was busted. Then they made it to where... Now I'm trying to think of old Overwatch stuff that was broken. Well, you get Angelmon now. Yeah. D.Va's pretty busted because now they just... Because they made her thing a toggle ability and that was really strong.
Mm-hmm.
And that's how they do it. They do it in turns, like with Hearthstone. For the longest time in Hearthstone, and I know you don't know Hearthstone very much because it's like a card game.
Yeah.
But there's the class Priest that was bad. Like, even with some expansions, they were kind of okay. But people would go into Priest in competitive, like in the ranking system, and be like, it's a fucking Priest, I'm just going to win. Now it's like, it's a Priest. I have to be careful. Again, Blizzard does their balancing in turns. It's not like, we're going to try and make it balanced. They're going to be like, no. We're just going to give people turns, like little kids, so that everyone can have the taste of the pie.
Yeah.
And that's what, and like I said in the beginning, if Blizzard doesn't like how their game is running, they're going to change and fix every single thing to make it how they want it.
Yeah.
They saw that tanks were part of the meta, and they're like, we don't want that. So we're just gonna go. Only the really big changes were D.Va and Roadhog, and then there was Anna. And what upsets me is, like, I still don't think, like, Mercy's viable. She's really not. When you have everyone that's better, like, Anna's better because she has the best burst heal. Lucio's better because he, out of all besides Zenyatta, he can actually do things and not just heal, you know? I'm not saying switching between Mercy's pistol is difficult.
No,
it's just...
I will say, if you can play a really good Mercy, you can be pretty useful.
Well, yeah, you can be useful.
There's something to... Because I know Richard plays a pretty spot-on Mercy.
Oh, there's some kind of lock on
it,
sorry.
What's it? Yeah, you gotta use copy-paste.
Oh, do we not have copy-paste? Oh, we do have copy-paste.
You have copy-paste.
Cool.
Oh, no, not copy-paste. Code scan?
Well, we don't have code scan? Oh, it's code scan. You're right.
Yep.
You know what I mean? And then, like, I was happy then Zenyatta got buffed because I actually liked playing him. Out of all the healers, I had
oh,
more
I love
fun
Zenyatta.
With him. I had the most fun with him.
I love headshotting people with tennis balls.
No, oh, with the nuts.
Well, yeah, the walnuts with the Nutcracker skin.
It looks so dumb. It looks so stupid.
But I love the visual, like, normal Zenyatta. I love the visual of just throwing a ball at someone's head and just, ah!
Yeah, he's, out of all the characters in Overwatch, he has the most, like, really cool design. And how he's a monk, obviously, and I have a...
He's an omnic monk, and
yeah,
I like that.
And he's just like, oh, alright, you know... Things come in waves, and I'll just shake it off.
That's
I'm
me.
Like, that's awesome.
That's me in the competitive scene.
I'll shake it off. You're trying to be insane. Yeah, I'm trying to meditate. My favorite meme is with, my favorite, like, meme comic, not even meme comic, my favorite comic's with, Tracer, Bastion, and, Zenyatta, and she puts googly eyes on Bastion, and then she puts googly eyes on Zenyatta, he's like, I feel reborn. fucking Zenyatta, so funny.
But
did you hear the new voice lines that came out as the time of this recording? With Genji, Hanzo, and Mercy?
No.
Genji's like, Hanzo, would you like some chocolate? They're Swiss. And he's like, I don't have time for this. Hanzo's like, I have time for this, and Mercy's like, Genji, I brought you chocolates, they're sweet. And he's like, oh, thank you, Mercy. Thank you, Angela. Because get in, he's being all cutesy. And then Genji's just like, Angela, I brought you chocolates, but they're not Swiss, though. And she's like, oh, all right, I guess I'll take them. I'm like, aw.
I love Genji.
He's back!
Jimmy-ken. It's Jimmy-ken.
I didn't know he came back. I guess I wasn't paying attention to the dialogue. Yo, even the ghost kid's like, oh, great.
He's like, ah, fuck.
Shit. Memer.
That's what everyone says when they
and
see you.
And his air guitar, it's his drive demon wins. Oh, fuck, it's a memer.
That's what everyone says when they see you.
But in a good way.
You walk... some yes, some
did
no.
Did I not tell you how, like, actually... I guess I wouldn't say popular, but I, like, actually, like... I guess how people actually like me? I'm... At this current time, again, time of this recording, I am the secretary of the gaming club at my college.
Okay.
My boy Justin went up. He's like, all right, I'm going to try and be secondary. It's going to be cool. It's going to be awesome. And then I stand up and I'm like, all right, I guess I'll apply too. He's like, fuck, I lose. Out of the entire class, I think. And then there was another guy there who was pretty cool. I would have voted for him. Guess how many votes I got? I got 22.
Nice.
Justin got 7 and the other guy got 2. So out of...
Well, you're good with the time.
Out of 31 people...
You're good with the technical shit and the details.
Not even technical.
Of games.
I guess I'm just really good at talking.
Well, we can have good conversations about details and shit.
Yeah.
That's what a lot of these conversations
are. Oh, I got a crit. Oh, but crit doesn't work the way it does in Persona. It feels good. I think they're weak to neutral attacks.
Well, they're fire, Phil.
They're weak to neutral attacks.
Neutral is not weak or strong.
Oh, that's right. We just read it off.
We just read about this. Fire, water. We don't have the water. Shit.
No, we don't. It will be fine. It will just take really long.
Venomon's at 25 HP.
Huh?
Oh. Wow.
I think we might lose.
That's a chance.
This is the first ever reset in history.
I feel like at this point I already bought some HP items.
Oh, I think we have a lot. It's just, I mean... Oh, that did nothing.
Check your items.
Don't worry. Renamon's coming up.
No, use heal!
No, that's fine. It's fine. We focus on damage in this game. Okay.
Alright.
We're good. Don't worry about it. We're fine. See, Renamon, we'll just heal yourself.
Oh my god, we have 44 HP caps!
No, that's small. We need to move on.
Jesus. 44 HP. Even though they're small.
No, I used it on the wrong one!
Phil.
Don't worry, Renamon's fine. Don't worry, Renamon's fine. See, she's fine.
Gargamon's like,
I mean, I didn't need that. I feel great.
I feel moderately adequate.
I feel a little bit better. I was struggling with a cold.
right?
It's gone.
I feel you.
I love that that's technically how HP potions would work.
Yeah, I'm alright.
just like, oh god, I feel terrible.
I think what the most terrifying like thing was like Pokemon with the sprays, because they're so in pain, and it's like, ah. Know what I mean? They're like, yes. Ah! Oh
my god, that was the luckiest shit that just missed Renamon.
That was funny as fuck. I love this game.
It's everyone else like, ah, shit, a boulder, Renamon, help!
Yo, you want me to use fire on this guy? I'm doing it. No. That's actually not so bad. He doesn't resist it.
He doesn't fight it. Yeah, I don't. Plant's not a good idea.
Obviously not. Oh wow, even Renamon's attacks do garbage damage.
Well, she's a plant type.
That's right, I forgot plant type. So it's all on you, buddy.
Yeah, Gargomon, I think, is actually like against their.
Oh, here's Meteor Fall 1. All right, Renamon, do us.
Oh god.
That's a lot of damage, but she's.
Oh
alive,
no.
She's fine. She's at 63 health. Calm down, boy. Calm down there, big boy.
Well, she's gonna get a lot of XP, unless she's already maxed. No, she can't be maxed out.
But yeah, no, I just found it shocked. I'm like, oh wow, 22 people actually enjoy my conversations. It's lit. I'm gonna heal her.
Oh,
maybe Renamon will be on
back
the
to Overwatch.
Oh, that's right, the Overwatch. Yeah, but yeah, no, that's the one. That's right. We're talking about healers.
One of the little things I liked about the small changes, the kill feed. I'm happy that they actually like show what kills people, and I'm so happy because now the headshots are treated with a red,
that's cool.
A red skull.
That's cool.
And I'm like, there we go, because I do so many fucking headshots with different characters.
I don't believe.
I get headshots with Torb. I get headshots with Hanzo, of course.
That's just the meme I have.
I also
that's my headcanon.
I feel like that's one of the reasons why I actually love playing Hanzo, because I'm not a good sniper with Widow, and we discovered like the reason why that's like, because I always thought it was
weird. Isn't she still like kind of bad?
Widow is going to be in the new meta.
Is she though?
Yeah.
Because I know, I remember that like really bad nerf that she got.
Well, because she can snipe the fuck out of Pharah still.
Well, anyone can snipe the shit out of Pharah. Even Soldier can snipe Pharah.
Yes, but I'm saying that like,
I missed.
She can still be useful as a sniper. The thing that I hate is that Hanzo gets a lot of flack, but it's really more the players that fuck with Hanzo.
Yeah, because it's like a Genji main.
Hanzo's not a bad.
It's like
character.
A Genji main. It's like, oh. Dad, I'm gay. Oh, that's fine, son. And we'll accept you. At least you're not a Genji main. Dad. Oh, well, Renamon's dead.
No!
It's fine.
She won't get any XP.
Is that how that works in this game, too?
That's how it works in most RPGs.
Sometimes. Not always. Sometimes, but not always.
Do you fuck
your mother with that mouth?
It's kind of depressing seeing her still laying on the ground.
Do you fuck your mother with that mouth? Well, sometimes, but not always.
But,
Oh, you got a defense down. That's actually good for us.
But he had an attack up.
Dead. It's fine. We're tanky boys.
But, the thing is that, I'm a Hanzo main that I'm not one of the...
Cause you're a Hanzo main?
Well, I'm not a Hanzo main anymore. I used to be, but then I picked up...
Oh!
No.
Oh, you have a revival capsule. No, you have three of them.
Heal Gargamon first.
I know how to heal.
I was worried you healed Growlmon for a second.
Oh, my slight fever is now gone.
But
Hanzo means. No, I love Hanzo. Right. Again, he reminds me of just Huntsman Sniper.
I'm a Hanzo player that, like, I'm very confident in my ability to play Hanzo. I don't play him in competitive unless, unless the in a quick play match. Because me and Richard, whenever we do competitive, we do some quick play matches first. We warm up a bit, especially with this computer, because it's worse than mine. It can run smoothly, but it takes like a Mac to warm up and get used to the models.
Oh, we attack. Oh, that's right. Panic's really bad.
So, we have a thing that gets rid of that. We have a panic recovery.
I don't care. We don't give a fuck. There it is. Perfect.
But I'm on some play that unless I get like five. There was one there was one quick play match where I got 5 or 6 headshots.
Oh god!
It was in Hanamura. They were running.
Not Hanamura.
They were running up to the, like the big gateway. In that, you know how the map
works? Oh, yeah, I know. Yeah, I know where
they were running up that ramp, and
I think my favorite thing from the beta was when I shot my arrow and a tracer ran in front of me, and I shot her right in the.
Oh my god! The funniest thing is I'm like, we were on the payload defending, and I'm like, they're not gonna make it back to the payload, but let's just see who's coming next if they did. And I fired a sonic arrow. A Reaper ran out in front of it.
My favorite thing is that you can kill people with the sonic arrow.
It's so funny. They're like, wow, I found their corpse.
It's like, well, I found them, and they are dead.
So don't worry. I love when you kill like the person that wasn't doing anything. So you're like, I did it, guys. And it's just like,
I did it, boys.
They're on the point, though. It's like, but I killed the soldier.
But I killed soldier's really good now, especially with his projectile. That's really stuff. Good.
I've been trying to like. I use quick play now to like really pick up characters.
That's what you do, man.
My Reaper was really good the other day.
But Reaper, really all you do Reaper. Is just keep your mouse in one direction and walk forward. And then Azaria ults and then you jump in, you're like, okay.
I make Richard really. Richard said the funniest thing. So my Reinhardt.
The bad.
No. It's actually pretty good.
I think my Reinhardt's really good. If I just get into the character, I start screaming like an angry German man.
I have a fucking.
He's German.
Right? I have to prove my.
He's German, right?
Yeah, he's German. Hi.
Hi,
still talking about Overwatch.
Memes.
You fuck. Ah, you fucking
my. You ripped that high five right away from him. I'll teach your grandmother to suck eggs.
And then he starts sucking on the glass. That's still my favorite. Fuck.
Yeah, no. Reinhardt, I have this fucking. I have to prove I'm the better one. with Reinhardt, so whenever I see an enemy Reinhardt, I have a 100% rate on killing enemy Reinhardts.
I want to fight you.
I always pin. There was one time where this Reinhardt was on the point, and Juan noticed this. I was coming in hot. I wasn't in position. I pulled off a full 90 degree turn mid charge and nailed him.
It's so funny when you get that like turn perfectly.
Cause you see them are like, ah, they're gonna miss, and then it's like a bullet curving. It's like
yo, we gotta curve the bullet like it fuck. Wanted.
I was like,
you have to curve the bullet.
Oh, you mean not Matrix?
I love Wanted.
I never actually watched
the comic. The comic was really good. I think it has a comic. Yes, it does.
Now,
why is there so much dialogue?
Welcome to RPGs, Phil.
No, not all dialogues are this fucking long. Cyber Sleuths are really long.
What's it? But the other day, Richard said something really funny about Reinhardt because I love pinning, and I get like fucking 13 to 14 charge kills per match.
I'll show you 15.
But like, and that's just on an average. There's times where I've gotten like close to 20 charge kills because I just I fucking nail my pins.
Do you though?
Yeah.
The bleeding.
On a bad day though, it can get me down to like.
On a bad day.
I can have a really bad day. Especially because when you charge, you're kind of putting yourself out there.
Yeah, I'm sure you put yourself out there.
Hey. But Richard always like is so mad at the other teammates because they don't push. That happens a lot in the lower ranks too. Which is why you kind of just stay in an abyss in the lower ranks. Because unless you have a full team of people that you trust,
welcome to push. Welcome to League of Legends.
Like, no one pushes on the team.
Every time. So what's really funny is that since I've experienced this, it doesn't come to me as like a shocker because you're telling me like, oh, this, that, people raging, people being tilted, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, yep, been there. Mm-hmm. I've been tilted. I've been salty. I've been this and that because it just sometimes just doesn't seem fair, you know.
We'll talk more about. Hold on.
But we have more dialogue.
We have more dialogue. We'll wait till after the dialogue.
I think actually we just finished.
All right, good.
Oh, thank God. Oh yes, we have 1,000.
That was the end of that quest.
Oh, thank God.
Now then. We'll see you guys in the next part.
Yes, we will. 9 hours, still going strong.
Farewell, viewers. Until we meet again.
Shut up.
Adieu.
Bye, guys.